All right, so we're going to be doing a live stream, our second show of the year from Westside Bowl on August 15th, and it's going to be at noon. And we think it's important that you get up and you do some day drinking with us while you watch our live stream. We're going into a pan on kind of a low flame. I got some butter. You can use oil if you don't want to use butter. Half a red onion, thinly sliced. And then I'm going to hit it with some salt just because that's going to help draw the moisture out. Alright, so the onions are pretty cooked down, just on a low temperature, not really trying to crisp them up. Then I got, I don't know, like a cup of sour cream. Just gonna chuck all the onions in here. Splash of Worcestershire sauce, a bit of salt and pepper, hella spicy mustard powder. But that's not necessary. Really just put whatever the fuck you want in there. Just, you know, S&P is the choice for me. You know, whatever you like, I don't care. Just a little tiny shot of lemon juice, because everything is better with a little tiny shot of lemon juice. You know, acidity, etc. And basically, it should eat like French onion dip, and like, that's essentially what that is. You could do 50-50 sour cream and mayo if you wanted. I did straight sour cream, because my lady hates mayo. But either way, whatever you want to do with it, make it taste good, homie. Alright, so we're gonna make lardon, which is a super pretentious French way of saying that we're just gonna make like crispy bacon toppings. Gonna kind of cut them evenly into some bitsies. I really like the thick cut bacon from Aldi's, the applewood smoked thick cut bacon. We don't really want to like fry the crap out of it. Again, we're really just trying to render that fat and make like a nice crispy bacon topping that's gonna eat like, you know, like a bacon bit, except actually made with meat. When you make potato pancakes, you kind of make a batter with egg and onions and shit. We're not doing any of that. This is going to be kind of more like hash browns. I got just a regular russet potato that I peeled. You don't have to do that, but I like to. And a grater with just the biggest grate. And I'm just going to grate the shit out of it. Alright, so we got that. I'm not going to rinse it or anything because basically the starch is going to hold it together. And just we got some just regular old canola oil in a pan. Pretty hot, and I'm just gonna throw this in. I kind of want to make like kind of a silver dollar size thing, and you really need less than you think you need. We want to get it fully cooked before the outside is burnt. Better salt and pepper that son of a bitch. And this is just like my non-stick omelet pan. You just got to go in hot so it kind of sets up. Okay, see, we're kind of crispy around the edges, so let's go ahead and flip her, looking for that nice GBD. But yeah, so ideally, you know, you can get a big pan and you can just crank out a ton of these. And then you can get your day drunk. Oh, and you may be tempted to fry these in the bacon grease. Use the bacon grease, you're going to get too much of like a burnt bacon flavor. So I actually lost the bacon grease. And I just did this in just straight oil. All right, so this guy's done. GBD on top, GBD on the bottom, definitely cooked. We're gonna hit it with a nice dollop of our kind of red onion sour cream. And the bacon. And boom, brunch snacks. Put anything you want on there. You can put some chives or some parsley, some green shit, make it look nice, do whatever you want. If you want to keep it dairy-free, you could put a nice little quenelle of hummus or something on there. Maybe make some hummus out of like some beans or something rather than chickpeas. Make some baba ganoush, man. The world's your fucking oyster. You can put some eggs on there. I'm not going to teach you how to make eggs because you should know how to make eggs. Down the hatch. Baller!